Even after removing the edge E5, all the vertices of G2 are included by the remaining edges E2, E4, E6. So, I can say that this G is not a minimal covering. This is called as a minimal covering. Now, if it possible to find another minimal covering with less number of edges, then the covering which is minimal and which is having less number of edges, the number of edges counted in the minimal covering having less number of edges is said to be a covering number. Okay. Now, whenever if you try to draw the covering as a subgraph for G1, let me draw E1, E3, and I will be getting two components. Both of them are star. What is a star graph? Star graph is, this is star graph with the two vertices. This is star graph with the three vertices. And this is star graph with the four vertices. And five vertices. Star graph with the four vertices. This is star graph with the four vertices. This is star graph with the three vertices, etc. When you see the covering, when it is drawn separately, the components will be a star graph. For this one, look at the minimal covering. This is the minimal covering. After removing E5, this is the minimal covering. You draw this. Look at this. This is one component and this is the second component. These two are star graph. Star graphs are nothing but they are trees. Okay. Now, what are the methods to find a minimal covering? Whenever you find a spanning tree of a graph G, that is always a minimal covering. When you find Hamiltonian circuit, that also gives you a minimal covering. And a graph will have covering only one if G has no isolated vertex. Suppose there is a graph V1, V2, V3, and there is an isolated vertex V4, and you cannot find cover for such a graph because you cannot cover the vertex V4. So covering exists for a graph G only when G has no isolated vertex. Suppose a graph is having n vertices, then covering consists of n by 2 edges, ceiling, this is called a ceiling, the greatest integer of n by 2, that is rounding off n by 2. In this example, how many vertices are there? 4 vertices. So n is 4. So what is n by 2? N by 2 is 4 by 2. 4 by 2 is 2. So rounding off this. So, a minimal covering for this graph consists of 2 edges. Is it true? Yes. Look at here. This graph contains 5 vertices. So, it will be having 2.5, rounding of this one, 3. So, the minimal covering of this graph contains 3 edges. Yes. Removing this E2, E4, E6. It's the minimal covering. That's what given in point 4. As I explained earlier, covering number is nothing but number of edges in a minimal covering which is of smallest size. Minimal covering is not a unique one. For a graph, you can have more than one minimal covering. Out of all minimal covering, the set which is having smallest number of edges, and you count those edges, that gives you covering number. And I explained about star graph. All the components of a graph, when you collect the components of the covering, always it will be a star graph. and we are having two theorems in covering. The first one, a covering G of a graph is a minimal covering if and only if G contains no paths of length 3 or more. So suppose if you find a covering for a graph G, which is taken as small g, they are giving the necessary and sufficient condition for this G to be minimal. So for a covering to be a minimal covering, this covering should not consist of a path length of 3 or more than 3. That means G can contain paths of length 2 and less than 2. You cannot have paths of length 3 or more. This is the theorem, and it is a if and only if condition. So I have to split the proof into two cases. One is if part, another one converse part. First, I have to take G as a minimal covering, and I have to prove that G contains no paths of length 3 or more. In the converse part, I have to assume that G contains no paths of length 3 and more, and I have to justify that G is minimal. Okay, now let me start with if part. Let me take this G is a minimal covering. What I have to justify? I have to justify that this G contains no paths of length 3 or more. I am going to prove this concept by using method of contradiction. That is, what I am going to take is, I am going to take that G contains a path of length 3. Consider the path V1 passing through edge E1, reaches vertex V2, then V1, E1, V2, E2, V3, E3, V4. So 1, 2, 3. This is path of length 3. Suppose G contains a path of length 3. What happens if I remove the edge E2? If I remove edge E2, what happens? What about vertex V2 and V3? Are they covered? Yes. Automatically V2 is covered by E1, V3 is covered by E3. So I can remove E2, therefore this G is not minimal, because after removing E2, still the property of covering is satisfied. Therefore this G is not minimal, which is a contradiction, because G is a minimal covering. So if I take a path of length 3, then G will not be a minimal covering. So I have proved the first part. The second part, converse part. Let G contains no path of length 3 or more. Conversely, let us assume that G contains no path of length 3 or more. What I have to justify? G is minimal. Okay. If G contains no path of length 3 or more, let me draw all the edges and let me draw the components of G. As I explained, as I have shown earlier, these are the components. I have drawn this E1, E3, and these are said to be the components. Similarly, you draw the edges of this covering, that gives me a component. This is one component and this one is another component. So if I draw the components, every component will be a star graph. Already we have justified this. When it is a star graph, all star graphs are trees. What we know about trees? Trees are minimally connected. What is the meaning of minimally connected? When you remove any one of the edge, the graph becomes disconnected. Since it is a tree, it is minimally connected. Suppose if I remove an edge from that, automatically one vertex will be isolated and that particular vertex will not be covered. Therefore, if I remove a vertex, the property of covering of vertices of a graph G is affected. Therefore, this G is a minimal covering. If this is a minimal covering, if I remove E2 or E6 or E4, what happens? If I remove E2, both V1 and V5 get isolated. If I remove E6, what happens? V3 becomes isolated. If I remove E4, V4 becomes isolated. So, G becomes uncovered whenever I remove an edge, because the components of minimal covering are star graphs. Therefore, G is minimal covering, hence broad. There is a four color conjecture. We know that in Atlas, the maps, all the maps have been colored using four colors. And this is a theorem called as five color theorem. And this theorem discusses about planar graphs. Every planar graph can be properly colored with the five colors. So if you take a planar graph that can be colored with five colors. Let us prove this by induction. What is the method of induction? First, we have to prove for all the trivial cases. Here the trivial case, let me take it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Suppose a graph contains one vertex. Can it be colored using any of the five colors? Yes, it's possible. When a graph contains two vertices, can it be colored using five colors? Yes. 3, yes. 4, 5. When there are five vertices, I can color the graph with five colors. Now, all and every vertex has been given different colors, which is a proper coloring. Now, after proving the trivial case, what I have to assume? I have to take that the result is true for all planar graphs with less than n vertices, and I have to prove the statement for n vertices. Okay, let me assume the property is true for all graphs with less than n vertices. Okay, now let me take a graph G which is planar with the n vertices. I am going to prove for a graph G with the n vertices, which is a planar graph. Since it is planar, the graph G must contain at least one vertex with the degree 5 or less. That is one of the property of a planar graph. Now, let me choose that vertex to be V. Now, let me remove this vertex from G and let me obtain graph G dash. Now, since V is removed, V and the edges that are incident with V will be removed. Since V is removed, G dash contains n minus 1 vertices. What is our assumption? That theorem is true for all less than n vertices. N minus 1 is less than n. So this property is true for this G dash. That is, G dash is a planar graph which is phi colorable. Now, let me add. Now I know that G dash is phi colorable. What I have to prove? Now G is phi colorable. Now let me insert this vertex V, which is having degree 5, into G dash, and all the edges that are incident with V are also included. So we are going to add V and all the edges incident on V to G dash. So you take, this is the situation, I am including V. V is having degree 5. So we are including V together with all the edges that are incident with V. Now, look at the vertices. Since it is degree 5, 5 vertices are adjacent with V. 5 vertices V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 are adjacent with V. That's why it is having degree 5. Now, all the 5 vertices, outside vertices, are colored as color 1, color 2, color 3, color 5. I have given all the 5 different colors that I am having. Now V is without color. Now I have to color V, but all the 5 vertices have been given 5 different colors. I cannot color V with these 5 colors. Okay, suppose there exists a path between V1 to V3 and successive vertices have been alternately colored with color 1, color 3, color 1, color 3, color 1, color 3. So, if there exists a path between V1 to V3, I am coloring all the vertices in the path of V1 to V3 by color 1 and color 3 alternatively. Suppose there exists a path between V2 to V4. Is it possible to have V2 to V3, V2 to V4? Not possible. Because I have to cross the path of, I have to cross the edge of this path V1 to V3. Since my graph is planar, I cannot cross like this. So there exists no path between V2 to V4. There won't be any edge between V2 to V4. Therefore, these two will not be adjacent. So since they are not adjacent, I can color this V4 by V2 and I can give color. Now V4 is, now I can use this V4 for vertex V, or else I can color this V2 by V4 and I can make use of this color V2 for V. Either one of the color can be used for V. Now all the vertices and together with V have been colored with 5 colors. Therefore, my graph has been colored with 5 colors with n vertices, which is a planar graph. Hence the theorem. With this, covering is over. With this, we have finished completely 4th unit. We have to move on to 5th unit. Thank you, guys.